Resident side are in Samoa to try and claim the last remaining places on the squad for next year's Rugby League World Cup.
They left on Tuesday after a comprehensive win over Tonga New Zealand resident side. Tagaoatele Osone Okesene has the story.
For most of these young men, touring to Samoa is a chance to further their league careers beyond playing for the local Auckland competition.
Just getting together like in this good stage in our league careers, that there is a chance of making a better thing in our league. So there's 5 spots, and looks like if we can play together, so everyone can just look good and hopefully just get one of those spots for the World Cup next year.
They're up against the domestic team in Samoa and expect a physical encounter.
There's always a battle against the rugby back home. I think by sending us over there, it lifts the profile of our domestic side back home and helps them, assist them in building structures and getting them familiar with the game itself.
While the World Cup Toa Samoa will depend heavily on their professional players from both the NRL and Super League, these players are out to prove that they're the next big thing for Samoa Rugby League.
The boys that I currently have are pretty much the top of the crop here in Auckland competition. Most of them represent Auckland or counties that have just played in the present wildcard competition, and a few of them represent New Zealand residents as well. And from that, a few boys have picked up warrior contracts.
Sky's the limit when it comes to league. If you can just perform and just play at your full potential, you know, the dream can come true.
Go the Toa. Now, the Blue Light event has been running in New Zealand for over 29 years. They're all about connecting the dots between local community and the police.
Last week, the Ōtara branch of Blue Light held a top town event for some local primary schools, but extended the invite as far as Huntly. Tagaoatele Osone Okesene has action from the day.
School-proud 8 to 12-year-olds from all over Ōtara have turned out for a special day at Ngāti Ōtara Park.
We've got a lot of teams here that came with sort of question marks, what is this all about? But they found out really fast that this is a fun event.
A total of 22 primary and intermediate schools, mostly from Ōtara, but also including Waikato, Manurewa and Papatoetoe, are all vying for the title of top school by being the best through the special obstacle course.
This is a fun event, and it's an obstacle course that we haven't seen here in Ōtara before.
Competing in the age groups, each team will need to do this course. Stage 1, eat 1 times dry Weet-Bix, then whistle happy birthday song. Stage 2, the whole team stands on a blue mat, lays another mat in front and keep making their way forward without stepping on the ground. Stage 3, slide along the benches and under the hula hoops. Stage 4, team walking on wooden sliders. Stage 5, through the tyres. Stage 6, jump up and down like crazy. Oh, okay, it's really 20 burpees. Stage 7, crawl under the cargo net. Stage 8, the whole team goes through the maze twice. Final stage, carry 1 team member over the finish line. Phew, I'm out of breath just talking my way through the course.
It was difficult in the beginning because we thought we were going to lose, but then we came back in the middle section of the race.
How much fun is it?
Really fun.
How did it feel to be carried across that last bit?
It was really cool because I got a break.
What did you like about the course today?
I like the big inflatable bouncy castle.
When I point to my left, I need everyone to go, woo-hoo!
The day's about building relationships and has come about thanks to a number of businesses investing back into their community. It's also a chance for police to have positive interaction with local youth.
We feel it's important that we get to our kids prevention-wise, just to let them know that the police are there for them, and if, just letting them know that we are approachable.
Even though the schools are competitive, it's been a chance to make new friends from other schools.
I was happy to see them from primary now, and yeah, glad to see them.
I think it's important that they have this relationship, with each other and also with Blue Light and the police as well. It's good for them to start getting involved with the different with all the different schools.
And the police do get involved in the day's activity, but they're slow starters in the race against a team of young doctors and teachers and parents. And while the Cops managed to come back from a bad start, the message they want everyone to take away from the day
is knowing that we are there for them to be safe and feel safe.